Limuna Uganda.
I come from the block, yellow and red, symbolizing a beautiful nation, gifted by nature.
Mata Tekere, Mata Uganda. Welcome to yet another edition of the Urban Fashionista. And this edition, it's about Miss Tourism Uganda 2018, the grand finale, the top three winners and the queens themselves. I know most of you must be wondering, what was Joram trying to say? I was greeting the entire nation using the Karamojong language, one of the languages from Karamoja region. My name is Joram and welcome to yet another edition of the Urban Fashionista. And on this particular edition, I will be talking to the reigning Miss Tourism Uganda Karamoja 2018. She's also the Miss Conservation Tourism 2018 and the first runner-up Miss Tourism Uganda 2018. Hi, Emily Ayen. How are you?
I'm doing great. And you?
Very well, thank you. You remind me so much of Lupita. Tell us, how is it growing up?
Oh, Lupita, I actually like her. She's my role model. You know, she has this color that I really like and almost my color. Mm-hmm. It's just, when I look at her, I look at myself in her. I feel like I'm Lupita myself.
What actually propelled you to join Miss Tourism Uganda 2018? Take us through your journey from Karamoja to the Nationals.
From Karamoja, you know, Karamoja is this richly blessed culture. It has got these beads, you know, I can see you having wine.
Team Karamoja!
Yeah, and I really wanted to showcase this beauty, and the only way I could really showcase this beauty is joining the tourism industry, because this beauty is what the tourists need to see out there.
Hi, Lebo, how are you?
I'm fine, thank you. How are you doing?
Very well, thank you. You have so many titles, eh? Like any particular juju you used? How did you get all these titles?
No, it's just luck and hard work.
I love the fact that you say luck. So how has that whole entire pageant journey been like for you, right from the time, you know, you contested in Miss West Nile and then you came to the grand finale? Take us through the entire journey.
You just have to keep on going, keep on pushing and struggling and fighting for what you want. And yeah, but it's been good, really good.
What's that one thing that made Lebu wake up and say, you know what, let me go give this pageant a shot?
The previous queens of last year, let me say, they were... some of them were friends to me, and then they went for Miss Tourism, and like they had a big change. They looked awesome. They, like, I felt like they had made it, and yeah, I felt like, Laura, you need to try this, and here I am.
Hail to the Queen Kankwanzi Margaret. Hi, Kankwanzi, how are you?
Hi.
I love how graceful you are. So how does it feel like you being the first runner-up from Kigezi, and then you advance to the national stage, and you end up winning Miss Tourism Uganda 2018?
Oh yes, I think it's really exciting and a blessing. I feel like being the first runner-up from my region, this was a second chance to give it my best. Mm-hmm. And it worked out well, and I managed to be Miss Tourism Uganda.
Great. I like your energy. Very soft, very composed, but the pieces that you create. So what were some of the inspirations that actually inspired you to come up with the pieces that you showcased at Miss Tourism Uganda?
My outfits for Miss Tourism Uganda were inspired by the hibiscus flowers. Yeah, so I had to create, I had to come up with a mood board and then make a few sketches and then derive the designs from a hibiscus plant. Mm. So the flower is so beautiful. I love the way it opens and I love the different details on it. So I got to use every single detail to come up with something. The petals helped me create, work with organza.
What is that one special thing that you believe you will always carry on for the rest of your life, that you learned so much from this entire journey?
Out of all that we've gone through in this tourism industry, I've loved to be determined in whatever you do. If you really, really want it, push it. Like, go for it. You shouldn't stay back. And I believe with that, I will carry it on forever.
It was really my idea. No one dared me, but I'm not a typical pageant girl, but knowing about tourism and this being an initiative for tourism, I love the industry, so I said, why not? Let me go for it.
So what inspired you to join the fashion industry? Did you go to school to study this, or you were that little girl that decided, when I grow up, I must be a designer?
First of all, growing up with my mom, she used to help make me doll dresses using polythene bags. Then she'd like create Cinderella dresses. And when I was at school, I was always drawing, but then I would always sketch like the Cinderella dresses and all that. I loved the fairy tale kinds of dressing. I loved it. It was so edgy, so nice. I just loved every detail about it. It gave this beauty to every woman, and I felt like, yeah.
How does it feel like staying with 36 females in the same space?
For me, it was really so challenging for the fact that every region came along with their runners-ups. So as this one loner, I'm the only one representing Karamoja. It was sad my runners-up didn't come. But you know, the determination I had, like what I was telling you, like it was just within me, I had to push on. I really wanted it. I wanted to showcase the beauty of Karamoja.
So you joining Miss Tourism Kigezi, you know, becoming the first runner-up and then advancing to the national stage, how was it in the national bootcamp? How was the experience like?
Wow, it was a little bit of the highs and the lows. It was challenging at one point, getting to meet a very big number of girls, about 36 from different regions. You probably don't know much about them. You're trying to fit in with all of them, learning about them, getting to know each other. That was a bit challenging, and there was a lot of hard work. Yes, late nights and so many other things. But then the experience was also good because I made these friends. I now have, at least from every region, I'm having friends, and I can get to talk to them about so many things, and we can work together.
Who was that one designer that got you by surprise?
Okay, so the thing is, I won't specify on one designer that got me by surprise, because trust me, every designer had something about them that was really amazing. I got to learn a lot. I got to get inspired by everybody's artwork. So when I looked at the garments, I saw art pieces. I didn't even see garments. I saw really created art pieces. First of all, I'll look at Abbas. I really loved the detail on his work. There was a lot of fabric manipulation, I'll say that. Yeah, so he did a lot of that with the satin and the netting fabric that he used. I love the details that he used, and the folding of the fabrics, how he played around with it, then even the cutting, the cutouts. Yeah, so he did a lot of cutouts, like showing of skin and all that. It was really beautiful.
Yeah,
man, I'm Ugandan.
Fast forward to the national bootcamp. How was the bootcamp experience like? Because to the urban fashionistas watching right now, by the way, these ladies go through rigorous training, an entire, you know, full month, them in camp, learning how to wave, how to talk, how to do all these things. How was the entire experience for you?
I should say bootcamp was bittersweet. Yeah, there are those moments where we kept crying. We really wanted to go back home, you know, morning drills, workouts. We keep running and jogging, you know, to keep fit. But all in all, there are good times. The meals, the tours, the trainers. Then there's just the time where we are laughing. Bootcamp was nice. It was fun.
What's your most memorable moment while you were in camp?
The snake challenge. Carrying a snake, you know, me, I know a snake is like, it's a serpent, it's evil, and yeah, carrying that thing, it was not easy, but I did it.
What happens on that day? Take us through the entire journey. What happens on the grand finale?
What happens on the grand finale? It's really a hell, like, it's terrible. The fact that it was my first encounter being on that very big, nice stage of literally celebrities that we usually see on TV. It's something that you've never dreamt of being there. Yeah. So it was so traumatizing. It was so scary. But you know, they take you through during the boot camp, like the final time towards the time of the show. They take you through. You try out on stage. You do some moves on stage. And after all that, you feel like, yeah, I got this. Yeah.
Who was your favorite fashion designer during the whole presentation? And then above all, what are those feelings that you had when you were advancing right from the top five to the top three to you winning?
The feelings throughout the eliminations, well, it gave me some nerves. We had so many, and every girl was putting their best game on. So it was really thrilling, but also a bit tight. But when we got to the 12, I was really happy, and I was feeling blessed that I made it to that stage at Serena, and there are so many girls that didn't make it there.
True.
So at the final stage, I was just happy. I was trying to enjoy myself, enjoy the runway, mm-hmm. give my best, answer those questions. Mm-hmm. So at the finals, it was really exciting. Mm-hmm.
Take us through the entire experience, you being among the top 12 on stage. How was the finale like for you?
At that point of the finale, we were like, come what may, I've made it to the top 12. What else do I need? But at the same point time, it was overwhelming. We had to make sure we are good for the Q&A, like mm-hmm. much as this top 12, this top three. So we had all that mixed feelings, and yeah, that was it for us.
What was your favorite segment? Who was your favorite designer, and tell us why?
My favorite was Fatuma Asha. She made me feel like a princess in a fairy tale. I loved her dresses, but all designers were perfect. I felt good in those dresses. It was massive.
And then you kept advancing from the top five to the top three. Did you actually see yourself win? The minute you were read in the top three, you standing with Margaret Kankwanzi, what was going through your mind?
It was exciting. It was really, really good because I wanted to retain the crown back home. The fact that Karamoja had it the other year, yeah. I was so determined. I wanted to really, really make sure I take it back home. But I guess the judges were honest.
And now that you are a national symbol, a national emblem for, you know, the tourism industry, what are some of the things that you plan to do during your reign?
There are several things, but I wanted to focus on some of the challenges of the tourism industry. And I came up with a road safety campaign. I'm also doing something on fashion, and I want to do culture.
Very nice. Tell us that something about fashion, because that's what the urban fashionistas love to hear the most.
I believe Uganda has a very rich culture, and I thought of ways of putting this out, and I want to come up with cultural fashion expos, yes, in various regions, and I think it will be a good.
Uganda, my homeland. Shabbat.